His Majesty has arrived. All rise for His Honorable Lordship, King Dakota. We are here today to discuss the trial of one introspective versus pure demon. Plaintiff, get your shitty stand out of the frame, or else the audience is going to know that we're using VHS tapes to prop up the camera. You stupid mother...
Oh. I guess he's dead. Anyway, commence the trial. And this is where I'd put my intro if I had such an intro, but I do not have an intro, so just listen to this really cool song. It is from Metal Gear 1. It is about Big Boss, 'cause you're fighting Big Boss in Metal Gear 1.
You know what's fun? Finding out that your 45-minute YouTube video has been missing a crucial element ever since it was originally uploaded. So now I'm going to have to reshoot that scene, put it in the 45-minute video, and re-upload that 45-minute video to YouTube. That's why the camera is in a different position, my hair isn't as greasy or spiky, and my face is now clean-shaven. Because this is a different day, and I'm having to do a reshoot. So what we're going to do is we're just going to pretend like everything is the way it's supposed to be. And now, I'm going to put this scene in its proper place so that the video makes sense. So there's this YouTuber named Introspective. And he made a video called How Brawl Players See Smash 4. When I originally saw this video, it triggered me to such an extent that I knew I'd have to make a reaction video to it at some point. I don't think it can be called a reaction video. I'm not a jinx motherfucker. You're not going to see his video in the corner of my screen and me being like... But at the same time, it's not a response video. Because I'm not responding to an accusation that he made against me. Is it an attacking video? I mean, I suppose I'm definitely punching up. He has like 69,000 subscribers and I have like 4. So I don't think he's going to give a shit that I'm making a response to his video. But so what's going to happen is I'm going to be watching the video on my other phone, because my phone is my camera and this is my other phone. So I'm going to be watching the video and just off the script, off the cuff, just responding and reacting to it. I don't know what the fuck you want to call it. But so that you aren't watching me watching another video, I'm going to be splicing in his video and you're going to see my response to it. You'll get it. Don't worry. I play Brawl. I fucking love Super Smash Bros. Brawl. Do you know why? It has motherfucking Snake in it. Alright? I love Metal Gear Solid. Tactical espionage action. I love Metal Gear Solid in all of its glory. You know what else I love? Dragon Ball. I also love Dragon Ball Z, but there's something about little girls in metallic bikinis that you just gotta love.
I'll take it from here, you clueless fuck.
Alright, so obviously that's not Masahiro Sakurai, creator of Super Smash Bros. I mean, it is him, the image is of him, but it's not his voice. That is an automated voice that the editor was able to type in and say whatever he wanted.
Hello, my name is Masahiro Sakurai, director of the Super Smash Bros. Series. Of all of my famed exploits, my finest work has to be Super Smash Bros. Brawl for the Nintendo Wii, the true epitome of a casual party game. With its unbearably slow engine.
So basically everything that he's saying here is sarcasm. Unbearably slow engine. What? Unbearably slow engine is something I would expect out of, I don't know, Breath of the Wild when it's just choppy and can't run smoothly because of its frame rate. Unbearably slow engine, even as somebody who's not, like, into the technical aspect of games, unbearably slow would mean that I would be able to see it and identify it. So that's just fucking false. Fuck you.
Horrifically unbalanced roster.
Alright, I'll give you that one, the unbalanced roster. But Ganondorf should be able to wipe the floor with a pink puffball named Jigglypuff. Ganondorf, the Prince of Darkness, should be able to wipe the floor with a Pokemon. I'm just saying.
A side mode that is more fun than the actual competitive play known as Subspace Emissary.
A side mode that's more fun than the actual competitive mode. What is your point here? I love the Subspace Emissary. It's a single player or two player campaign, depending on if you have friends or not. So single player for me. And it was fun as hell. It was able to compel a story with awesome cutscenes without saying a single word of dialogue. It was unbelievably talented for Sakurai or whoever was a part of it. So you're phrasing all these things to be sarcastic, but I can't see the sarcasm in that statement. What's the problem with having a campaign mode that's more fun? Are you saying that you don't want fun in your video games? Like, Mortal Kombat 10, or more, actually, fuck Mortal Kombat 10. Mortal Kombat 9 had a campaign mode with cutscenes, and it was actually really fun, considering that fighting games usually aren't very good for their story mode. This one was actually pretty good. It was pretty okay, because it had, it included the story of, like, the first three games, and it was, like, a really interesting callback to it. I really enjoyed it. And yes, I would say it's more fun than the, than just fighting. What the fuck is your point?
Though I've decided to take a Brawl exclusive player whose name shall remain anonymous, and give him his first copy of Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo Wii U, complete with all of the characters, and DLC.
How the fuck do you switch to Ivysaur?
Yeah, bad news, Brawl Vet. You can't. No Ivysaur. Or Squirtle. Good, bad, I don't know.
Speaking of top tiers, I keep pressing B when I only have three Pikmin, but nothing's happening.
Yes, Brawl Vet. Olimar only has three Pikmin in Smash 4.
They really put Dr. Mario back in the game, huh? These clones are such a waste of a roster spot. That could have been Wolf.
Obviously, this is all supposed to be sarcasm, but he's fucking right! Clones are a waste of a fucking roster spot. But then he follows it up by saying it could have been Wolf, which is another clone. Well, I mean, honestly, Wolf was more than just a clone. He had his own, like, fucking attacks and different damages. That's like saying Luigi is a clone of Mario. He used to be. He's not really that much now. Fuck you. Introspective.
Oh, holy shit, they have the guy from Xenoblade in this game.
As a fan of Final Fantasy VII, fuck you. You're trying to say that Brawl players are fucking retarded? Fuck you.
Oh, holy shit, they have the guy from Marvel vs. Capcom 3 in this game. And look, they gave him Snake's headband as a nice tribute.
As a mild Street Fighter fan, fuck you. Fuck you. That's obviously Ryu, you stupid motherfucker. And I know that the joke is that the Brawl players are stupid, but nobody's that stupid. Fuck you, introspective. And yes, that brings up an interesting point. Snake's headband as a nice tribute. Where the fuck is Snake? Huh? My favorite fucking character from the Oh wait, I'm not wearing that shirt anymore. Where is fucking Snake? introspective.
Wait, there's no tripping? Does this game have any competitive mechanics?
Nobody thought that tripping was a good idea, except for the development team, and they came to their senses. I'll give that to you. The joke is that Brawl players think that Brawl is the absolute pinnacle of greatness and that everything in the game is how everything should be, but I'll give that to you. Tripping was stupid.
Ganondorf still sucks, huh? Well, it was worth checking.
Yeah, unfortunately, Ganondorf still sucks in Smash 4. He sucked in Melee and in Brawl. If only there was something that could occur to make Ganondorf more like his canonical appearances in The Legend of Zelda, as opposed to a Captain Falcon ripoff.
Smash Tour. So, is this Smash 4's version of Subspace Emissary? No. No, it is not.
Again, I'm not really sure what point you're trying to make here. Smash Tour fucking sucks. Am I not getting this? Like, is this a level of satire that goes beyond my intelligence? Like, is this satire, within sarcasm? Because, unless I'm mistaken, Smash Tour is generally looked at as being shitty compared to Subspace Emissary. Am I right about that? Like, is there anybody in the world who actually likes Smash Tour over Subspace Emissary? Because this video has been entirely sarcasm, and whenever the Brawl player brings up a valid point, we're just supposed to take it as, oh, that Brawl player is fucking stupid, ha 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 ha, but that would imply that for this joke, Smash Tour actually is more interesting than Subspace Emissary. But unless I'm mistaken, it's fucking not.
Just go back to Melee, you fucking scrub.
Now, if you listen closely, you'll be able to hear the radiation coming from the TV giving me cancer. I don't know if you can hear that, but there's a very faint frequency coming from the TV. It's probably giving me cancer, but, the only cancer in this video is Introspective's perspective on Brawl players. Oh, and of course, Smash 4. You can hear the fan in my Wii U, as it runs the disc, because my Wii U is old and close to its deathbed. So I got my GameCube controller here. Fuck GameStop. My old GameCube controller broke, so I had to get a third-party controller. Don't mind that. Might take a while to load because, as I said, my Wii is pretty close to its deathbed. The Wii's got to be like 11 years old now. Huh. Oh yeah, that brings back some memories. Alright, I'm gonna go with my main Snake. And let's go up against Ganondorf. Another guy I like. Cardboard box. Fuck you. Alright, I'm not... Yeah, see, there's the damn slipping. Everybody hates. I don't really know how the mechanics work. It may be like, so if you push down... Oh, damn it, they saw me. Haha, got the exclamation mark from Metal Gear. If you push down with like a quarter, if you push down taunt with like a quarter of a second, it'll do a codec call, which is really cool. It's really hard to do because it's, you literally have to do it in a fourth of a second, I think. Damn, man. And I know as soon as I fucking do the codec call, it's gonna fucking, Ganondorf's gonna come over here and fucking kick my ass. And it won't, the call won't go through. Oh, I got it. Ganondorf, stay the fuck up there. Don't fucking do it. Don't. Yeah! But I'm guessing that probably doesn't really impress you guys. So let's crank it up to nasty. And let's go against my other main, Link. And we'll go to Link's turf. Now, to be honest, there are some things I don't like about Snake. For example, every character in Brawl has three taunts. Except for Snake, because they decided to make all three of his taunt buttons the fucking cardboard box. I can't show you what buttons I'm hitting. So I guess you're just gonna have to take my word for it that I'm not hitting the same button. And that did always bother me about Snake, is like, they could have had a lot of things, like him smoking, or him eating a ration. That was one of my main complaints. See, I'm hitting all of the different taunt buttons, and it's not doing anything. I am a fucking pleb. I just got killed by an environmental factor. So yeah, it does suck that all of Snake's taunts are a cardboard box. Oh, I just grabbed Link's bomb. Yeah, fuck you, Link. You like bombs, huh? Where a fucking grenade? Oh, goddammit, I can never throw it in the right direction. So, a really cool thing about Snake is the tactics behind him. So, like, down B is planting C4. And, like, down A is planting a landmine. I'm pretty sure I just lost to a computer. My credibility on the internet has been... Oh! I have a chance to redeem myself! Did it. So, you know, I love Snake. All of his moves are really awesome. But I mean, I also love Ganondorf. Let's just go back here. But the problem with Ganondorf, right, is that, he's a Captain Falcon clone, so this is a basically a meme before memes existed because of how stupid this move is. It's this punch, right? He's like, and it's basically the Falcon punch except purple, and it basically never ever hits. because most characters just don't get hit by it. And that's his neutral B. So, of course, if Kirby absorbs Ganondorf, they both have this punch ability. Ganondorf is really powerful, but he's too slow to really be effective. And I think that's Ganondorf's biggest downfall. Which is disappointing. I mean, he's the king of evil, and he really can't hold his own in Brawl. Ganondorf was, of course, introduced in Melee, and as one YouTuber, Relax Alex, theorized, he was only introduced because they could just give him all of Captain Falcon's moves. And they had all the time in the world to make Ganondorf the appropriate, more appropriate to the canon of his games for Brawl, but they didn't. They just gave him the same moves as he had in Melee. So, that kind of sucks. God damn it. Well, I mean, he is the hero of time. One thing I do like about Ganon is his taunts. Like, that's from Melee. And he's got his Twilight Princess sword. I think that's pretty cool. Yeah, I really wish there was a more competent Ganondorf. A more competent Snake with, like, better taunts. Alright, I got one last surprise for you guys. I'm gonna play fucking Olimar. Now, I actually wasn't super into Olimar. And I'll put him up against my other main Sonic. I wasn't super into Olimar when I first played Brawl, but after watching Relax Alex's video explaining Olimar, and how all the different Pikmin do, like, different amounts of damage, and, like, they go different distances, and there's clearly a lot of thought went into Olimar, and I think that's pretty cool. So Olimar can, of course, pull out six Pikmin in Brawl, but his up B, or recovery, is really bad. So basically, when, in order to not die, you have to, like, chain your Pikmin up, and it's really ineffective. I know what the intention was. It was to make it so, like, the more friends you have, the better your chance. But see, like that. Like, if that yellow Pikmin was with me, I would have survived. But, no. And, of course, Olimar is more or less defenseless without his Pikmin buddies. Which is the theme of Pikmin, so that was carried over well. I can't deny that there was good design in Olimar's character. Ah, shit. Fuck you, Sonic! See, the red Pikmin does fire damage. I mean, you should really just go watch Relax Alex's video on it, because it was really cool, and it inspired me to like Olimar. And, like, I wouldn't say Olimar is a main of mine, but I do definitely like him, and I do like playing as him, because there's a lot of tactics behind his character, much like Snake. And so the yellow Pikmin does electricity damage. I think I lost this. Fuck you, Sonic! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you, Sonic! He's a derpy motherfucker. So there's really only one more thing I have to show you, and I don't know if Stage Builder is a thing in Smash 4, but I know it was introduced in Brawl, and I think it's pretty cool. What the fuck? What? What the fuck is going on? I'm scared. Please secure your wrist strap to safely contain hype. What? Whoa. Whoa. Well, they changed even the names. Pitiful, inept, feeble, lazy, normal, tough, fierce, mighty, cruel. Oh, and they have different stages now. Look, Fountain of Dreams, that's from Melee. Hyrule Castle. Let's go to Hyrule Castle. A tranquilizer gun?! The knife?! The knife is where the rocket launcher was. That's his forward smash. Tranquilizer gun. His tranquilizer gun is where the Nikita was. Oh, it runs out of ammo. You have to reload it. Oh, there's all this electricity around Snake's recovery, the cipher. What the fuck was that? Was that a new taunt? The cardboard boxes is down taunt? Of course. You can't have Snake without the cardboard box. He's smoking! He's smoking! Hold on, Link, sorry, I need to put you to sleep, buddy. I need to see this. It does fire damage when he throws it on the ground! It's taunt! Oh, did you hear that? It was the Metal Gear sound of when your health is diminishing. Hold on. I'm sorry, Link. I need to see this. Oh, that is so cool. Oh, that is awesome. What's his other taunt? Side taunt. And then the down taunt is the cardboard box. Oh, that's so cool. So his side B is actually putting dudes to sleep. Which is exactly what it was in... I was going to say that's exactly what it was in the games, but side B wasn't a thing in the games. But he did tranquilize a lot of dudes. Especially in the tanker episode, you just had a tranquilizer. Oh, and I can see that its range isn't all that great. And you reload it. That's so cool. So the up B actually does electricity damage now. But is there a way to reload it without... Because that's the question, right? So you have one... Alright, so one, two, three, three shots, and then you have to reload it, which isn't accurate. I think the actual tranquilizer gun had, like, 16 shots or something. But that is so cool. I really admire the attention to detail here. Oh, I think one. Okay, so if you hold the shield button and press forward B, he actually reloads it. So you got 1, 2, 3, reload, which is the normal way to do it, or 1, and then, hold on. Alright, no, that one didn't count. Yeah, see, 1 and then reload. Oh, that's so cool. One thing that Snake was able to do in Brawl is if you gently touch down, he can, like, crawl. But this version was cool enough to allow him to do a shank, which is reminiscent of Snake Eater. I wonder if they changed up anybody else. Let's see my other main, Ganondorf. And I don't really care for Dr. Mario. Wait a minute, Dr. Mario's in the game? Whoa! That's pretty fucking cool. I wonder if Ganondorf has any new costumes. Oh. Hold on. Link? Oh my god. It's fucking Ocarina of Time up in this bitch. Alright, so let's go ahead and get this out of the way. Falcon Punch. What the fuck? What the fuck is that? What the fuck is that? He's doing his floaty thing from Ocarina of Time. I don't know how practical it would be in battle, but it's a much more canonical resemblance to his actual character. What's up, Link? What's up? What's up, motherfucker? Huh? Huh? You like this jab? Huh? Fuck you, Link. But here's the best thing. You ready? Boom, motherfucker! Yeah, that's right. His down taunt, which would normally be that sword that you guys know, which is actually his sword from Ocarina of Time because I have the Ocarina of Time skin on. If you hold it down, it actually becomes an attack. Alright. Now that's all fun and good. But let's crank things up a bit, shall we? So there's Ocarina of Time skin and Twilight Princess skin. That's pretty cool. I think they still got the silver and gold colors. I like how Ocarina of Time's Highland Shield stays the same color, whereas Twilight Princess doesn't, because that was in Brawl, which I didn't really care for a whole lot. Alright, so let's do some Ganon. Now wait, I see the Hylian Bridge here. Wait, what does this say? Hold L for alternate stage. Okay. That was R. I'm so stupid. Oh, awesome. Alright, so let's check out Link's taunts. Oh, that's from Ocarina of Time. I mean, Melee. Twilight Princess? Twilight Princess? Ocarina of Time. I mean, Melee. God damn it, why do I keep saying Ocarina of Time? Well, that's pretty cool. What the fuck? Whoa, wait. I pressed down for like 0.4 seconds like you would do with the Snake Kodak call, and he did a different taunt. I'm playing the Ocarina. Why is it only doing that one? Oh. Pushing the D-pad on the GameCube controller makes the different sounds. Yeah. Yeah, do 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 do. That's so cool. Does he have any others? What if I push side taunt for a few seconds? Oh, that's epic. So the melee taunt, which is side taunt, if you push that for a few seconds, it's the Twilight Princess fairy taunt, but it's got Navi's voice because Ocarina of Time. So he's still got the claw shot, as opposed to the hook shot. But you know, I gotta give him credit for doing all this. I think all of his equipment is still, Wait, hold on a second. I can't tell because of this stupid not pausing. Alright, hold on. No, it's still the bomb from Twilight Princess. And that looks like the Twilight Princess bow. But that is not the Twilight Princess boomerang. It's not exactly the Ocarina of Time boomerang, and it also doesn't make sense for adult Link to have the Ocarina of Time boomerang. But that was also in Melee, so I gotta cut it some slack. It's still really cool though with the Ocarina. Alright, chill out. So what other changes we got here? Hey look, it's Dark Pit. Oh hey look, original Pit. That's pretty cool. Got some Ike. Huh, Ike's got some badass armor. Oh wait, what are my costumes for my main, Snake? Yeah, that was in Brawl. I don't know if that was in Brawl. That one's in Brawl. That one's in Brawl. That one's in Brawl. A big boss! Well, Big Boss wouldn't be at Shadow Moses Island, so let's go with Distant Planet, the Olimar stage. Yeah. Oh, they fucking changed it. So yeah, I'm a Bigu Bosu now. How do I zoom in? Okay, there we go. Yeah, see the eye patch? That's how you know I'm Bigu Bosu. Fuck you, Ganondorf. Yeah, time for you to take a little nap. Oh wait, alright, that was in Brawl, but I wanted to point it out again, because the C4 is in the shape of the butterfly like it was in Snake Eater. What the fuck? Did Ganondorf just fucking phase? Oh shit, Ganondorf's kicking my fucking ass. What is that phasing thing? I'm a little concerned. Damn it. I'm an idiot. That was pretty cool though. I'm sorry I'm not doing much commentary, I'm just having a really fun time. God damn it. I am, not doing brawl players any favors, am I? I'm sorry that I'm not the most competitive person. But I mean, I've never really been. I'm not super into fighters. I'm, more about, you know, story and having fun. Finally got to God damn it. Cardboard box. Ganondorf, just let me have my fucking fun. Don't be a dick. Alright, I think this video has gone on long enough. Perhaps I'll upload more Project M videos in the future. You know what? I'll close out with some Olimar. I don't know, I just think this is pretty fucking cool. I mean, the fact that I was able to do this on my Wii, I mean, you guys are seeing the Wii. Alright, so I got 3 Pikmin. Huh? Oh, I got 4 Pikmin. But it's still not letting me draw 6. Oh shit, is that fucking balancing? Also, there's no slipping. I can't really show you that there's not. You're just gonna have to take my word for it. What the fuck? That wasn't no fucking chain grab. Ha, Captain Falcon, you got 8 and you stupid motherfucker. So yeah, Olimar's got a fucking jetpack now. Instead of this fucking chain grab. That's pretty cool. So that means that even without your Pikmin, you can still do that jump, but it's not very great. Alright, this video has gone on long enough. Perhaps I'll upload more Project Fucking Mewtwo! In Brawl? Alright, you know what? Nah. I got to do this. I got to do this. Alright. This is for all the marbles. Mewtwo versus Ganondorf. I'm sorry, I take it back. That's not the stage I wanted to do. Thought it was. It's not. I want to do it here, Bowser's Castle. Look at this fucking made-up stage by the people of Project M. Do it. Do it. Okay, then. Are you okay? Oh, shit! That's not gonna... Boom, bitch! I just done did reflect it. You wanna play fucking tennis with Ganondorf? I am the motherfucking tennis master. I did this shit in Ocarina of Time before you were even... Well, actually, you were, weren't you born in, like, 1996 or some shit? Boom, bitch. You can't fucking touch me. I'm Ganondorf, King of Darkness. Alright, I'm having a difficult time touching you, as it were. Boom, bitch. Come here, come here, come here. Alright, you're not gonna... Are we gonna do this again? I mean, you guys saw it. I put the AI on fucking 9. And it's still falling for them same old tricks. Alright, chill out. God damn it. Don't you dare laugh at me. I am the one who laughs. Your darkness only makes me stronger, Mewtwo. You Sephiroth, Frieza wannabe. Oh, goddammit, I did it too soon. But I knew it was coming. I read that read. Do it. Knew it. Saw it coming. I knew that read. Just stop it. It's not gonna work, Mewtwo. We got a regular Lucario over here. That reminds me. Mewtwo was around in Melee. Not in Brawl. So, what would happen if Mewtwo got a hold of a Smash Ball? What are Mewtwo's color costume? Got some fucking armor? That's pretty fucking dope, I gotta admit. Alright, so I'm gonna turn on... God, I keep wanting to end this video, but there's just so many cool things. Alright, I wanna put on Smash Ball, because I wanna see what happens if Mewtwo gets his hands on a Smash Ball. And then I'll end the video, I promise. My phone is telling me that my battery is low, probably because I've been doing the video for so damn long. I'm sorry, okay? That's his taunt. I'm not really a Mewtwo player, so I don't really have any fucking idea what I'm doing. I just want to get my hands on a Smash Ball because I want to see what happens. Well, fuck. I guess that really is a damn good Pikachu. Hey, Team Rocket? Alright, let's see it. What you got, Mewtwo? Galagorn! I like his taunts. They seem like something a smug-ass Pokemon would do. What's his down taunt? Yeah. Mika Pikachu, stop it. Just stop it. Alright, I want to do the Galagorn one more time, and then I'll stop, okay? I'm sorry, this game is just so much fun, I can't stop playing it. Super Galagorn! Alright, let's stop this before I play anymore. I can't help it, it's too fun. Let me know in the comments if you want to see more Project M. As I said, I'm playing it with a GameCube controller on my fucking Wii, on my shitty ass TV. You don't need a PC to do it. Anybody can fucking do it. I know how. I found it online. I would put up a link in the description, but that link might be dead by the time you see it. I don't know. I'm just saying, I got Project M on my fucking Wii, on my fucking TV, and it's awesome. I'm not a Brawl player. I'm a Project M player. I'll see you guys later.